Wake up, knight. You must take up your arms again. This is all very confusing. I know. Focus. Breathe. It will all become clear soon. You were fighting in the last great battle for Britannia, when King Arthur's adversaries marched against the once and future king. You have committed dreadful acts to fulfill your destiny. Do you remember the earth trembling? Can you recall the gathering of terrible armies? You saw Camelot burning and watched the power of magic tearing apart the world at its seams. You led knights and monsters into a deadly storm of fury and blood. You destroyed the ladies of the sun and the lords of the winter. You have killed King Arthur, and with his dying breath, he struck you down. You both died. And yet, you both live. You have unleashed something that cannot be stopped. The tide of madness and pain will swallow us all. I have brought you back to end this nightmare, Sir Mordred. I want you to go on a nightly quest. I want you to finish what you have begun. Kill King Arthur, or whatever he has become, after I took his dying vessel to Avalon. Sir Mordred, living and breathing again. But is he truly alive? I wish I could talk to him, but I can't just yet. Serves him right anyway. I've set this dread knight on a dark path, and for now, I can only watch where it takes him. I've brought back King Arthur's nemesis, and wonder if I made the right choice. Mordred did the impossible, after all. Almost killed the king who cannot be killed. And that's how the nightmare began.
I'm here to teach you some manners, lad.
I can hear you. Let me out.
Take a look at this. More trinkets.
Open the door, whoever you are! Help me, and I will help you.
Well, well, well. Sir Kay, King Arthur's seneschal, in a dungeon rotting away, a hero's reward. An honest and capable man, but a bit dull, like an untended blade.
Sir Mordred, the Scourge of Britannia is back. Avalon is not a place for your treacherous kind. Are you real? Or just a ghost? Tell me, Mordred. Do you remember killing me? Help me escape, traitor. Then we may talk.
I've already told you. Avalon, the island of the fallen knights. And this is Castle Camelot. Yes. Not the one that you remember, though.
I keep my promises. I will help you, Mordred. The powers that rule this land decided to trust you with our fate.
I don't know how to feel about that. But soon, you must make your very first decisions.
Great. That's my arm over there.
Finally. I feel more useful now.
You think a sword makes you less useless?
We must get out of here. Go to the door and let me handle this.
I told you that you will pay for this.
What the hell is he doing out of his cell?
Surprise.
One down.
That's it. I was just getting warmed up. I hoped for something more.
This is the Warden's room. Prepare for battle.
Sir Kay, you are really persistent, but I can't. can't let you walk free.
You don't have much choice in the matter now, Warden.
To serve. Your Highness?
Now we should find the one who is truly in charge here.
Treasure. Look what I found.
It's quite a crowd.
You know very well that diplomacy was never my strong suit.
Fight and die like a man!
Awaiting your command.
Your Highness?
Ready to fight.
Too late.
I am ready.
What must these soldiers serve anyway?
That would be Sir Towelin.
Lead me to him. I want to explain him that this is my castle now.
as well, traitor. You probably don't remember me. I am just a walking corpse, cheated out of his death. And I will make everyone suffer for this injustice.
He was Sir Tuellen, a once noble warrior with two sons, both knights.
I fell in battle, like we all did. But instead of gaining new life in legendary Avalon, I've returned as a lost one. Let me rephrase it, traitor. Camelot is a sacred place, reserved for the once and future king. That is the law. But I spit on the laws of the Lady of the Lake. I'm not afraid of her. Lost ones can't perish. This is our curse and blessing. He is not. The unholy storm wrecked the ship that brought the dying king to Avalon. And the raging tempest, something was waiting for the ship. And then the darkness took the king. Arthur is beyond the Bridge of Sorrows, dwelling on the accursed land of Midnight. Whatever you do, you need more than a blade to break my curse.
Let me cut you to size.
I am here to serve. Your Highness?
Your head is mine.
I am ready. The battle is over, and you must make a choice, Mordred. This is merely the first in a chain of similar decisions that will eventually determine what kind of leader you will be. Tell me, what will happen to Camelot?